I'm a little happy they didn't do this in the anime. This is like some Luffy shit, bro. Like, you could... That's like some Sanji shit from Whole Cake, you know what I'm saying? Or like, when he looked like that. Like, you can't be sad when he look like that. Bro looks goofy. Bro literally said, oh yeah? Who's gonna stop me? Who could possibly stop me? As Asklad did back then. Can you stop me? As Asklad did. Bro looks like a villager bee, like Bozo, but he's a Jomes Viking, so he's probably nuts. Might makes right. I mean, that is facts, though. That is facts, though. So how do you combat it without might, you know? We all know real men keep their real feelings bottled up deep inside. And you don't show them, you baka. His mental illness is trying to like dehumanize him. And make him a sheep. God damn. How could the sheep understand the work of a shepherd? Bro doing mental gymnastics right now with himself, bruh. Damn! Dangerous to that philosophy. A single sheep can lead the entire flock astray and toward a cliff. I was not expecting that answer. Huh? What? Well, my mama told me, if you don't got nothing nice to say, don't say it at all. So I'll just walk away. He's trying to help the most and minimize the oppressing, but still oppressed though. Just let it happen though? Did you let that happen to your face merely so you could have... Damn! But bro didn't even like... Kanu was like trying to ask him questions. He just ended discussion. But he's making him make a decision right now. He's done being toyed with. So that's something. Bro's laughing. This is very weird.
Oh.
Bro, Orphan has walked away?
Nope.
Nope. Bro did the equivalent of got the shit beat out of him just to go up to the king's face and be like, knock it off before I get angry, huh? No? Oh. Well, in that case, bro did the old Joseph Joestar technique. I'm getting on my last nerve, pal. You best back it up. That's enough. He looks so much more kind. Sheesh. Damn. Why is shit so fucking beautiful, bro? Yeah, you'll come fuck it up. Man, I don't know. I'm conflicted. Because, like, running away, bro. Like Canute said, his power will continue to grow. More and more people are just going to be fucked over who aren't Vikings. More and more people are going to die. So what are you going to do when you run away? Beyond the king's reach, using methods, methods different from yours. The people who can't live in the world you create. But that's not how it works, though, right? Like, it's not like they can just magically segregate all the people who fits with Thorfinn's ideals and all the people who fit with Canute's ideals. Like, Canute's entire plan relies on slavery and seizing people's land and forcefully making people work to make food. Those are the type of people who would go to where you are. They're not going to just go over there. They're going to be like enslaved, you know? It feels a little too idealistic in my, like, in my opinion. He thinks eventually he'll get betrayed. I mean, I guess he just overtook some place already with slaves. Just because he's a new slave master don't mean it's any better. Canute isn't that evil. I mean, he's killing innocent. I mean, innocent as far as innocent as a human can be. He basically set up a farmer or a slave owner, I guess. It's a little too innocent to call him just a farmer. He set up a slave owner, who was one of his dudes, to seize their land for the government because they have farms. So he's gonna still use the slaves that are probably there. I guess ending slave, like, they say they wanted to end slavery, but, like, I don't know. Hey, this chat argued that slavery ain't that bad. There's no need to state your points. Okay, that's true. I guess I am also thinking about it from, like, my POV, because we kind of live in a world, like, where I live. Well, there can be a slave to the corporations or whatever, but slavery is not legal. So I'm already in a place where slavery is illegal. So, like, maybe from my POV, I'm like, I know it's possible, so just end slavery. I don't even know, like, was there even a civilization without slavery at this point? That boy Thor's. Look at the sky, bro. See, peace talks can be just as challenging, you know? Thought-provoking. Bro is distraught. It feels like Thorfinn is, like, bringing out the best in Canute. And then his king internal mental illness is, like, getting to him, I think. He left! Damn. Dude, look at the sky. Holy shit. I bet Floki understands now. Floki, after seeing that, has to know Thorfinn is Thor's kid. 100%. Damn! Huh? That really works. He considers Thorfinn an ally, which is insane. So he's just trying to make a place for the most amount of people to be saved. Even though some will definitely still be oppressed and enslaved, he's trying to make the ratio as much free as possible, and then the rest of them can try to run to Thorfinn, I guess. That is insane that actually works. I am pretty surprised that works. Like, I don't know. It has to be because of Canute's previous relationship with Thorfinn. He saw how much Thorfinn changed. That had to be it. Because he saw Thorfinn when Thorfinn was at his, like, worst. Right? Canute's Danish forces dwindled to a mere 16 ships because they didn't have any food to feed them all. Nobody
Uprise.
Damn, we're going through a time skip. Look at his hair, it's long again. Or it's getting long. I wonder if, like, was the real Kanu like this, or are they painting like a bad guy in like a really good light? Because I kind of like him. Or not kind of, I really like bro. That boy Einar gone. He didn't break his foot, did he? Oh no. Where do we even go from here? To the land beyond the sea. Sheesh. But I thought they were wanting to go to. I thought they were wanting like to end all war and slavery and shit. Damn. Holy shit, bro. A place more appealing than death. God damn, bro. Jesus, dude. Like, what can you say to that, bro? What can you even say to that? Damn! God damn, dude! What a fucking goat. Brother! We'll build a peaceful land? Let's fucking go! Oh my god. Beyond the sea, let's create a country without slavery or war. Damn! Look at their hands, bro. Jesus, this shit is fucking beautiful, bro. Rest in peace, Arnhide. Dude. Oh my fucking god. And they're going back with Leaf. Let's fucking go! Dude, where are we going from here, you know? Like, what are we doing? We're gonna go build a fucking city out in Vinland? Bah! Omar? He don't want the cred? Omar might become a pretty good dude too. I mean, he already kind of was. And already changing his mind on a lot of things and like deciding. But I hope he can continue that track. I want to be like you. Sheesh! Well, your circumstances were also a little different, though. So was D. It feels a little... I don't know. I guess there's always injustice, but it's just crazy Ketil got to live. Maybe I'll turn around and be like, what a great... Well, maybe I'll be a great person from now on or something. I don't know. But like, I don't know. First, you'll probably fucking die. I know that goes against the whole point, but I don't want Thorfinn or Einar to kill him. I just want him to like perish, like from natural causes, maybe. Bro, didn't take a single silver piece. He left all the treasure. He don't need it where he's going, bruv. He don't need money. There ain't no money there. Money can't buy you nothing in the wilderness. Roald, son of Grimm. Who's Grimm? Do we know a Grimm? I don't know a Grimm, but... W. Roald! Roald! That boy Roald. Grim got a son.
Rip Arnhide, looking over the water.
That's so sad, bro. This arc's already over! No!
No way it's over.
Sheesh! Look at bro! You see, bro? And he got his little boo thing!
Sheesh! Carve it.
They working now too? Jesus Christ, bruv. Welcome to the Kalos gang. Yes, sir.
Kalos gang. You see that one? That one ripped open on Saturday.
Kalos gang.
Carve it into your flesh. Carve it into the land. Life's so good for no reason.
What the fuck? Thorgil. Why the hell Thorgil going? Where the fuck is bro going?
Where the fuck Thorgil going? Bro's going on his I Have Enemies arc, I guess. Carve it. Carve it. Carve it. They're all farmers.
I'm surprised old man made it, bruv. How the fucking old man make it? All the way here. I mean, I like old man, but I thought his house was dying like 10 episodes ago.
Carve what you feel into me.
Who's saying this?
That's a little... If only Vinland Saga does anime hands like this, bro. In my life, I've always endured. I thought pain was the way of the world. Damn. Light literally returned to his eyes.
Pater probably knew Arnhide for a while, huh?
I thought Pater was blind. How would he be blind, bruh? He was closing his eyes so he wouldn't see the pain of the world, like Fujitora. But then instead of actually blinding himself like a fucking psychopath, he just kept his eyes closed. Like, if I don't want to see something, I can just close my eyes, you know? I can just do that. I don't gotta like I can just like do that. So, you know, then somebody like Luffy or Thorfinn came around and go, oh yeah, it's a good thing I didn't like cut up my eyes or anything, right?
Hasten, try not to make every single anime reaction a One Piece reference. Carve that encounter into me.
Who's saying that? What is that supposed to mean? I don't understand that.
Their story was so tragic, bro. Like, dude, literally everybody got a happy ending this season. Literally everyone, but them. All of them died.
You know how fucked up that is? They were like the most innocent ones. And Kettle, nah, fuck. Kettle survived a fucking war from the king. From the king. He survived a war and didn't die and kept his land in his name because Thorfinn. That is the best case scenario he could have possibly had. The only thing he lost was Arnhide, and that's because he killed her. He did that. He came out unscathed. He lost a few men. The only person who hurt him was him.
Kito's existence is so miserable, he would have been better off dead.
I mean, then he can go die. So, but you know, at least he has the option to choose. Unlike Arnhide, who was fucking murdered.
Man, I really thought Arnhide.
They're in Iceland!
Let's fucking go!
Oh my god! Duh.
Well, I guess I accidentally got spoiled on that. I thought they were going to be end credits. I can't lie. That was just like a perfect end credit moment. And I just got spoiled next episode.
You know, it's cool though. I'm happy. You know, I'm still happy. It's just I found out a little earlier. So, my fault.